What inspired me? The situation in this country and in the world in general. I grew up in Nazi Germany, so there's plenty of reason as a kid already to realize that politics shouldn't be allowed to be what they are. My family became refugees. We are from an area in Germany, Silesia, used to be called Bohemia. We fled from Allied airstrikes and Russian tanks, and we got away with our lives, and we fled to the Baltic Sea, and our parents very generously allowed us, each kid, five kids, to take something along, which was very difficult because luggage was little, precious, and so forth. But I was allowed to take a bag of puppets, of hand puppets. And when we lived as refugees, I made my first public puppet show at age 10. So that and the education of having to make your food by your hands work, namely that all us refugees, there were many, many others with us in this village, made their livelihood by gleaning the fields behind the farmers. So you went behind them, you picked the potatoes, you picked the root crops, and you picked the grain. Then you threshed it, and you cleaned it, and you put in a little coffee grinder if you had one, and you made sourdough. And this was an old-fashioned village where baking was done communally in a big stone oven. And once a week, everybody, including the refugees, were allowed to bring their loaves, and the baker would bake them for you. And each family had a sign on their loaf, so because they all looked the same, so that you could recognize what was yours. And the puppets grew bigger and bigger because I realized if they're bigger, you're above the traffic. If you have a drum and cymbals, you're louder than the traffic. So it can be done to bring your messages across. Yep, that's how it started. It's unbelievable what's happening in the world. It's a protection against the refugees. The refugees are results of wars that capitalism is deeply responsible for, but doesn't want to take and pay for consequences. So it's pretty horrible. Yeah. We had a play that was done in response to a group of women, Puerto Rican mamas in New York, who lived up on the east side of Manhattan, and they asked us to make a street play because they all had gotten the same letter. And the letter started with, "We regret to inform you," meaning that their son had been killed in the war. And it was a disastrous situation. Puerto Ricans who can't elect the president were the main cannon fodder in the Vietnam War. They were put in the worst situations. They got killed like flies. And New York City, having such a big Puerto Rican diaspora, was suffering badly from that. So we made a little play, and we played that play basically all around the globe, everywhere, wherever we went. It showed them that this way doesn't work. Needs to be a better way. That's what the kids are saying right now. I hope they go a little further and talk about the Second Amendment, that holy cow. They don't do that yet. They stay away from touching it. It's America's holy cow. Thinking of it as if it was a God given that a person needs a gun in order to be free. Now you're not free when you have a gun. You enslave yourself to that instrument. That's all it is. The whole dumb population is educated to this stuff, to believing that this is this this is what freedom is. You have the big enough gun. If the other guy has a gun too, you have the bigger gun, so you're the freer person. Yeah. Huh. Good. Free and dead. Yeah. When you have a sick person, like a little idiot, in charge of a huge empire, you know, that is super dangerous. I mean, the guy talks about nuclear weapons as if it was a toy at his desk that he can push a button and do something with. He doesn't even realize, I think, what he's talking about. He's not even a toddler yet. It's amazing to have that phenomenon. The two-dimensionality of modern life is deeply suspicious to us, sorry to say. We think you can go out and touch people and do things, and musically also super important, the whole idea of that the machines can do that for you. Yeah, sure they can, but it's imitation, it's flat. It's not the real stuff. The real stuff is when they throw tomatoes at you and when you're there. So it's better. God is just the sort of an extreme case of human speech. It's when you don't take things for granted, when you create it anew, when you make it into picture or into music or into words. And then that isn't arbitrary matter. It's the matter that results from the situation that you live in. So if that's what art is, then art is protest. I think in the world, that's the potency of art. That's what it does in China or in Africa or in Europe or here, all over the place. You get a bunch of friends together and then you make art. And you figure out what needs to be done. And out of that you make art. It has nothing to do with money. Nothing at all. There's so much garbage in American garbage. There's so much value that's cardboard and fabrics and everything's all available in New York City's garbage cans or in Burlington's.
What do you hope that people like take away from the art you're creating or the shows they see?
Piece of bread. It's too hard to say that they go and help changing this goddamn miserable system. That they recognize it, that they don't fall into the traps of the system, that youngsters grow up not grabbing and becoming money freaks, but realize that life is a little different from money and do things accordingly.